I remembered them.
Please stand for the pledges. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please join me in the Texas pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. Please be seated.
Good evening, and welcome to the Joe Garcia GANAS Awards. My name is Dr. Ramona Morin, and I am the proud director of the Family and Community Engagement Department. Tonight, we are here to celebrate our students who demonstrate a sincere desire to pursue excellence. Before we begin, we would like to introduce our special guests who are in attendance tonight. From our Board of Trustees, we have Mr. Johnny Beach, our secretary. Daphne Stanley, our assistant secretary. We have our award-winning superintendent, Dr. Ricardo Lopez. We have Dr. Ida Perales, our interim chief leadership officer. We have Dr. Jason Adams, our chief academic officer. We have Daryl Dodds, our chief financial officer. We also have Dr. Babetta Hempel, our executive director of student services. Michael Areola, our interim executive director of leadership. And Tara Sauls, our director of multilingual programs. Thank you all for being here tonight. Now we will watch a special video tribute.
I'm Rick Lopez, your proud superintendent. Today we're showcasing excellence through the Joe Garcia Awards. And the significance of this program is more than you can comprehend. Some of you are probably wondering, how was I selected? Some of you are wondering, that's no doubt that I'm selected. Whatever you're thinking about these awards, please remember a few things. First of all, you were recognized because of your potential. And being recognized for potential is very different than any other award because it's about what you're going to be if you stay on the right path. You're not there yet. Actually, the journey never ends. You're going to be working on yourself academically, how your attitude is, how your character is, your entire life. But you see, you were selected because they see that if you keep working on yourself, you are going to be a leader. Heck, you may even have my position one day, and I would love to see that. The heritage that is recognizing you with Joe Garcia as one of the founding Hispanic men, or just people, in the entire Garland ISD is something you should cherish. He broke boundaries so people like us can have opportunity. So with this award, be very proud. Hold it dear to your heart because you can carry it for your entire life. But know that we're expecting great things from you. I look forward to seeing those great things in the years to come. Enjoy your award and congratulations.
And now please welcome Mariachi Cielo Azul from Jackson Middle School.
Wow, what an amazing performance. Let's give them one more hand as they're making their way out. And how many of you were singing along to some of those songs? Yes, I just couldn't help myself. Well, it's a pleasure to be here with you all this evening. My name is Tara Sals, and I'm the Director of Multilingual Programs here. And it is my pleasure to introduce to you all our keynote speaker for tonight. Dr. A.C. Cristales was born and raised right here in Garland, Texas. He navigated a challenging upbringing after his father's departure when he was just 8 years old, leaving his mother to raise him and his brother alone. Despite these obstacles, he graduated from high school in 3 years and immediately began his higher education journey at Richland College while working here in Garland ISD as a bilingual classroom aide. His dedication led him to become a third grade newcomer teacher while pursuing a Bachelor of Interdisciplinary Studies from the University of Texas at Dallas. He then earned a master's degree in education administration from Texas A&M University in commerce at age 23. Rapidly rising, he assumed the role of assistant principal at 24 and has served for 8 years in this role. He is currently the assistant principal at O'Banion Middle School. Woohoo, where's O'Banion? All right. Dr. Cristales is also an educational consultant and motivational speaker. For the past decade, Dr. Cristales has been a voice for advocating for educational empowerment and organizational culture, delivering professional development programs across the nation and Central America. He earned his doctorate of higher education from Texas A&M University Commerce in 2022, focusing his research on Latino student support and the impact of family engagement on academic achievement. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Cristales.
Okay, I don't like to just stand in one place. No me gusta quedarme en un lugar más. ¿Está bien? Is that okay? Oh, come on. You got to be a little bit more excited than that. Right? Do I have to do a little ta-da-da-da-da? I don't want to do that. Then they'll be calling for the ambulance. So, no voy a hacer eso. So I want to start out by saying this. That our life, nuestra vida, our life is defined by moments. Lo voy a decir en español porque yo sé que hay gente aquí que habla español. Nuestras vidas son definidas por momentos. Our lives is defined by moments. And for the next 10 to 15 minutes, I'm going to share a couple of moments in my life that have defined me. And so let me just go ahead and start. Now, I don't remember much when I was in kindergarten. No me recuerdo mucho cuando estaba, cuando tenía 5 años. Don't remember much, but I do remember this. I was excited. I was excited because I was going to get to go to school Watson Elementary with my brother. My brother's 4.5 years older than me, so he was in fifth grade. I was excited. And then I get to school, and I don't know any English. Okay? Didn't know any English. No sabía inglés. Mi papá es de Guatemala. Andale, mira, guatemalteco, mira, chapín. There we go. One chapín, though. That's like, I just left the man. All right. Oh, okay, 2, 3, okay. Andale. Y my mom was from Peru. Ah, peruanos también. Okay, muy bien. So guatemaltecos y peruanos. Ven como hay tres nomás, ¿verdad? Pero está bien. So, I didn't know any English. First language spoken at home was obviously Spanish. And so I get to Watson Elementary School, and the teacher's asking me if I knew my colors, and I didn't know what the heck she was talking about. You know what blue is? I don't know. ¿Qué? You know what red is? ¿Qué? I didn't know. Because at that time, and I'm going to go way back, students. I'm going to go way back. Back then, all I had in English at the house, the only thing that I had in English were 3 VCR tapes. And I know the students are probably looking at me like, what are VCR tapes? Google it. Okay? You know Google or TikTok it. You'll find something on the, oh, look, VCR tapes, right? So VCR tapes, that's all I had. And I still remember the 3 VCR tapes I had. I had Rambo Part 2, Ghostbusters, and Michael Jackson's The Making of Thriller. Oh my gosh, I did. And you're laughing, but that's the only English that I had in my house. And so when I went to Watson Elementary School as a kindergarten student, I didn't know red, I didn't know blue, I didn't know 1, I didn't know 2, but I knew Thriller. But I didn't say it right, because I just my first language was Spanish. Mi primer idioma era español. So I said trile. Trile. You know, like cornflake. Huh? Trile. Hasta lo hice salsa merengue. I made it salsa merengue. Trile, trile, da 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 da, right? But trile was not going to help me as a kindergarten student. And so what they did at that time, Garland ISD at that time only had one school that offered the bilingual program, and that was Back Elementary. So living close to Watson Elementary, they bussed me all the way to Rowlett, and then they put me here. Here you go. You're with Latinos. Like, oh, man, this is great. Comen tamales, comen frijoles, hablan español. They say trile like me. I loved it. And so I was in bilingual, kinder, first, second. After second, they said, hey, you know, you have a strong foundation in Spanish and English. We're going to transition you into a regular education classroom. So another defining moment. They throw me into a regular education classroom, and guess what? Teachers don't know how to say my name. Now, we said AC. AC is pretty easy. Kind of be hard to get AC wrong, ¿verdad? But Abiecer? That was my first name. Some of you are like, what exactly? I see someone las maestras. That's how the teachers were. They're like, Abiecer? They're like, what? What's your name? Like, Abazer? Ebenezer? Abazazizer? I was just like, do we have to go back to kindergarten and do the syllable clap? Abiecer. Three syllables. Abiecer. And so I didn't like school at that time, but let me tell you another reason why I didn't like school, not just because they didn't get my name right, but I didn't like school because during that time, I was 8 years old, and during that time is when my father decided to leave. And so my mom was raising me by herself, and I'll never forget that. I'll never forget being angry as an 8-year-old kid. I'll never forget thinking that it was my fault that my father wasn't a part of my life. I'll never forget thinking that what did I do wrong that my father didn't want to be in my life? 8 years old, and I'm already thinking that. And I share that with you because it's real and it's honest and it's authentic and it's part of my journey. And that's one of the things that Dr. Lopez talked about in that video, that there's things that happen in our life, right, in our journey that shape who we are. And at 8 years old, I was upset and I didn't like school. And I was angry because my dad wasn't a part of my life. So I started acting up. Me empecé a portar mal. Just seeking attention. I was watching gangster movies on VCR. Again, Google that. Watching Boys in the Hood, right? Was listening to gangster rap. I'm just being honest, 8 years old, right? Tupac, Biggie. I was watching, and you know, I'm Latino, soy Latino, so you know what I was watching. I was watching Blood In, Blood Out. Sangre por sangre. No, no, you know, don't pretend like you haven't watched Sangre por Sangre, all right? You're probably going tonight and watch Sangre por Sangre. But I was watching Blood In, Blood Out, and I was thinking I was a vato loco forever, but I wasn't. But that's what I wanted to portray. And so I was getting in trouble, and then another defining moment. I was being sent to the principal's office, but I'll never forget this, guys, okay? So where are my sixth graders at? Raise your hand if you're in sixth grade. Okay, very good. This is for you. So right before I go to sixth grade, my fifth grade year, there's a teacher who actually wanted to teach the last week of school. I didn't understand that. I didn't understand why she wanted to teach the last week of school. And so I get into class. We have, again, 4 days of school left, and I'm sitting in the back, and this is my English teacher, and she's like, hey, guess what? I want you guys to go to your next grade, and I want you guys to be proficient. I want you guys to be great writers. And so we're going to review everything that we've covered this year. And I'm like, miss, all I want is recess. Sixth graders, do you remember that when you had recess? Don't you miss that? Yes, yeah, see, one honest person, right? And so I wanted recess too. In fact, I wanted movies. I wanted VCR tapes. But she wasn't having it. She wasn't having it. She's like, no, we're going to review. I said, what are we going to review? She's like, we're going to review nouns, verbs, adjectives. I'm like, miss, I know nouns, verbs, adjectives. I know it. Nouns, a person, place, or thing. Verb, action. Adjective describes a noun. I know that. And she's like, you know what? Just be quiet. Let me teach the class. Because I was that kid. And then you know what happened? I'll never forget this. Walked into the classroom a pretty girl. Never forget. Her name was Angie. See, that's how I remember. Angie walked into the classroom, and guess what? she sat right in front of me. And I was like, you the MVP. Like, you are. I said that. And I said, Miss, I got adjectives. I have adjectives. I'll show you how I've had adjectives. And I started to break it down. I said, Miss, she's A, adorable, B, beautiful, C, cute, D, delicious, she looked delicious, E, elegant, F, fine, G, gorgeous, H, hot, I switched it in Spanish because I'm bilingual. A, adorable, B, bella, C, chula, D. She said, déjame en paz. Déjame en paz. She's like, she raised her hand and she said, Miss, he keeps bothering me. And so I left her alone for about 22 seconds. Because back then you couldn't stalk somebody on their Instagram. You couldn't slide into DMs. Back then you actually had to get telephone numbers. So I tapped her on the shoulder again. She turned around and I was like, hola. Hola. And she said, Miss, he keeps bothering me. And Mrs. Craig stood up and she said, a baser, because that's what they called me. They didn't. A baser, didn't I tell you to leave her alone? And what do you think the kids did? What happens when a teacher calls one student out? What do y'all do? Oh, thank you. Say that again. Exactly. And I didn't like, ooh. I didn't like, ooh. Even my friend was like, ooh. I was like, yo, what's up? Like, even your friend turned on you, right? ¿Pa qué onda? Mi camarada, ¿qué onda? Compa, ¿qué onda? And I stood up, and I said something very disrespectful to the teacher, and she sent me to the principal's office. I can't tell you what I said. But you know what? We're in star season, so I need you to use your inferencing skills. All right? There we go. So she sent me to the principal's office, and here's the thing. I wasn't afraid of the principal, okay? Mr. Drummond, God, I love him wherever he's at. I think he's still in Garland somewhere. But Mr. Drummond, I wasn't afraid of him because they used to paddle back then, guys. They used to actually get a paddle and paddle you. And here's the thing. I wasn't afraid of that. You know why? Because my mom's Latina. My mom's Latina. He would paddle me and I would smile. And he's like, why are you smiling? I'm like, dude, my mom hits harder, man. Seriously. My mom would get that matamosca and go to town. She got the matamosca. How many of y'all been hit by matamoscas? Don't raise your hand. Don't do that. Your mom's going to get you with the matamosca if you raise your hand. But my mom was to get that matamosca, and I was a big Ninja Turtle fan, right? And so my mom was like, ¿Quieres Leonardo? ¿Quieres Leonardo? Aquí está Donatello, right? Oh, my gosh. So I was suspended. Suspended from school. The last week of school. And I'll never forget how disappointed my mom was. Never forget how disappointed she was. But you know what? It's about persistence. See, persistence is the quality that supports you even when you go through obstacles. I want you to look at the screen. Persistencia es la calidad que te soporta, que te apoya cuando pasas por obstáculos. Persistence is that quality that supports you when you go through obstacles. And the key word that I said is when, because you will go through obstacles. You will go through challenges. But what quality is inside you? So as a 12-year-old kid, 13-year-old kid about to go to middle school, angry at the world, getting suspended, at that moment, I saw my mom cry. She picked me up from school, and she was crying, and I knew I wanted to be different. Now, I didn't know that back then, but I am so appreciative now that my mother showed up because she could have been like, you know what, forget it. I don't care. He's suspended, whatever. But she did it. So what I want you to do right now is I want you to clap for your parents because they showed up for you. That's a blessing. They showed up for you. And you know who else showed up for me? One of my greatest teachers. In that picture, I have two of my greatest teachers that I've ever had. And this is a teacher who didn't know the pain I was going through. This is a teacher who didn't know my dad wasn't a part of my life. This is a teacher who didn't know that my mom would pick me up after school, and instead of going to play football and soccer with my friends, I would go with my mom and my older brother to clean daycare offices. I would go to downtown Dallas to clean small business offices. She didn't know that. She didn't know the pain that I was going through, but she knew something else. And I'll never forget this conversation. The summer before my freshman year at South Garland High School, That's right, go Colonels, I mean Titans. My summer before my freshman year, I go visit Mrs. Purvis, and she asked me one question. She said, how are you doing? I said, I'm doing good. She's like, are you sure? I said, yes, ma'am. She's like, are you sure? I'm like, yes, ma'am. She's like, because I remember when you got suspended, and I didn't like that. I didn't like that reputation. I'm like, miss, why do you remember that? Like, you're the social studies teacher. Remember, I knew all 50 capitals. She's like, this is why I remembered. Because I remember when you got suspended, I went home and I told my husband, I need to pray for this kid. Tengo que orar por este niño. And she looked me in my eyes and she told me, don't you know how special you are? Don't you know how much potential you have? And I kid you not, as a 14-year-old kid about to start high school, I started crying because no one had ever told me how much potential I had. I had a mom who loved me, but she never told me that. But here was a teacher who said I had potential. You're here because someone sees the potential in you. You're here because someone believes in you. And check this out. That was 2 years ago. My fifth grade teacher is in that picture with my mom at my doctoral graduation. I told her she's a part of my legacy. I said, I am who I am because of the words that you spoke in my life. And so that's why I want to tell you guys, thank you. You can clap for that. Yeah. And so I want to tell you, persistence, right? GANAS. What Joe Garcia showed, GANAS, right? To break down barriers, to persist, even though there are obstacles. Someone believes in you. I believe in you. I may not know what you're going through, but I know there's greatness within you. So parents, they clap for you. Now I want you to clap for them. So guys, remember that there is greatness within you. You have potential. You can change the trajectory of your life and your family's life. Thank you very much. And that's my daughter. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your inspiring words. Now for the moment we've all been waiting for. At this time, Mr. Joe Garcia's daughter, Kelly Garcia, and Dr. Lopez will present the awards to the students. Unfortunately, as you can tell on the table, not all of the trophies were delivered in time, so the students will take pictures with the trophy, but we will deliver the trophies once they arrive to the campus, so each student will receive their trophy. The students, you can see that they're making their way to the right of the stage, and they are going to be escorted by school representatives, and they will stop right here at this backdrop to take a picture. So when your child is approaching the stage, parents, that row right in front is saved for you. So that way when your child is on the stage, you can come to the front row, take that picture, get that moment, like Dr. Crisella just talked about, take a picture of that moment, and then head back to your seat after you take your picture. Okay? All right.
Austin Academy, sixth grade, Sofia Rangel.
Austin Academy for Excellence, Principal Dr. Lakeisha Ryder.
Sofia Rangel. Karime Urieta Peña, Luis Beltran for seventh grade, Gabriel Cortez, Camila Perez, Zoe Ortiz Cantú, and for eighth grade, Everett Herrera, Diosis Garay Ferreira, Iris Consuelos.
Bussey Middle School, Principal Dr. Brandon Maxey.
Bye. Bussey Middle School, 6th grade, Genesis Martinez. Alfonso Briones. Olivo Valde Esquivel. For 7th grade, Camila Becerra. Maite Briones Serrano. Steven Manzanares Rosales. For 8th grade, Jacqueline Nunez, Israel Tolentino, and Giovanni Velasquez.
Classical Center at Brandenburg, Assistant Principal Isis Tosado Rodriguez.
6th grade, Maya Mata, Leo Zamora, and Miriam Hernandez. For 7th grade, Lili Covarrubias, Nahum Mendoza Alvarado, and Manuel Ceballos. 8th grade, Annette Alegría, Devani Sauceda Espinosa, and Marvin Treviño.
Coil Technology Center, Principal Ms. Sherelle Wilson.
6th grade, Orlando Pacheco. Anabela Rocha, Yaretzi Moreno. 7th grade, Naima Valdovinos Arenas, Giancarlos Hernandez, and Annalie Barrientos. For 8th grade, Jonathan Echagarruga Roca, Ariel Martinez, and Mariana Guerrero.
Sam Houston Middle School, Principal Mr. Hernandez, Assistant Principal Mr. Gibbons.
6th grade, Carlos Gonzalez Esquivel. Azul Adame and Emma Blanco. 7th grade, Isaiah Mendez, Nancy Hernandez, and Oliver Barrera. For 8th grade, Kaylee Romero, Leobardo Diaz, and Bracy Hernandez Barrientos.
Hudson Middle School, Principal Dr. Ashley Wong.
6th grade, Cassandra Schauer, Isabella Schauer. Stephen de la Garza. 7th grade, Vanessa Donovan. Jaden Gonzalez. Tora Colath. 8th grade, Michael Rodriguez, Roslyn Ramirez, and Juan Paulo Lira.
And now Jackson Technology Center with Mr. David Dunphy, the campus principal.
For sixth grade, Alexander Garcia Enriquez. Juliana Garcia Lucena. Brandon Juarez. Seventh grade, Carlos Alberto Cervantes. Ariana Gonzalez Esquer. Alisa Sanchez. Eighth grade, Stephanie Navarro. Anthony Lugo. Brianna Maldonado.
And now Lyles Middle School with their principal, Dr. Ansel Howard.
Sixth grade, Jamilet Jeep, Aiden Fraga, Adriel Merlin. Seventh grade, Stephanie Rosales. Yarexi Ramos. Alexander Diafana. Eighth grade, Michael Ochoa. Litzy Trujillo. And Joseph Duelos.
And now Memorial Pathway Academy with their principal, Dr. Diana Montgomery.
Sixth grade, Edgar Mendez Pequeño. Joy David Rodriguez Venera. Gianella Valdomar Torres. Seventh grade, Reina Morales Tapia. Jordi Suarez de Moya. Anderson Asensio Guerrero. Eighth grade, Celeste Silva Sanchez, Ariana Llerena, and Giovanni Torres Izaguirre.
And now we have Abania Middle School with their assistant principal, Dr. A.C. Cristales.
For sixth grade, Cristian Ontiveros, Viviana Slider, And Yesenia Canas. Seventh grade, Isabela Manzolo Dominguez. Baldo Bravo. Diana Vargas Bueno. Eighth grade, Ashley Bonilla. Michael Argueta Moran. And Jorge Suarez Carvajal.
And now we have Schrady Middle School with the proud principal, Ms. Devonia Maddox, and Dr. Crystal Bush, their assistant principal.
For sixth grade, Oscar Varela Soto, Rebecca Alvarenga, Ariana Gutierrez. Seventh grade, Alina Santa Cruz, Tristan Lares, Daliel Flores Santizo. And for eighth grade, Marcela Guajardo Alanis, Micaela Muñoz, and Aiden Martinez.
And now for Sellers Middle School with their assistant principal, Alfonso Calderon.
For sixth grade, Kaylee Humana, Damian Rodriguez, and Joancel Ortega Fuentes. Seventh grade, Alexander Rendon Gutierrez, Ana Castillo, Santiago Vargas. Eighth grade, Emily Ramos, Alvin Escalona, and Gael Martinez.
And now for Webb Middle School, we have Mr. Sanchez, their assistant principal.
Sixth grade, Adriana Galvan. Ryan Hernandez. Seventh grade, Sergio Garcia. Anaya Cruz. Eighth grade, Alexis Cardenas. And Joel Cervantes.
Let's give one more big round of applause to all of our student award recipients. And now we will have closing remarks from our award-winning superintendent, Dr. Ricardo Lopez.
Let's give another round of applause for Dr. Cristales and everything that he's done for our children from O'Banion. You're a great role model for our students, and it's an honor to hear your story. Thank you. You know, Dr. Cristales' parents had a very powerful message. And for those of you that don't know me, I'm Dr. Ricardo Lopez. I'm the superintendent of the Garland ISD. We got a great big district, and it's like one big family. And today we're honoring your children, your grandchildren. So let's give the students a big round of applause. Now, the one thing that Dr. Cristales talked about was sometimes you got to hear you have potential. Students, you heard it today. You got an award for it. They didn't ship all the awards. You're still going to get one when they all come in. But understand, now you can never say, nobody told me. I have potential. Today, you even got a reward to prove you have potential. But the other thing that he said in his speech, he talked about the love of his mom. She might not have ever told him, but she showed him. She was there every day. Parents, times have changed. And I need you as a superintendent to help me raise these children. Can you help me? No, can you help me? Yes. Will you help me? Yes. So I'm going to let you know a few things that we need to do that never change in time. Okay? Kids, how many of you have cell phones? Actually, you don't have a cell phone. That's your parents' cell phone. Parents, that's your phone. Don't forget that. You determine when they use it. You get to go look through it. It's your phone. We have to remember that as parents. I have four girls. They don't like it when I say, give me my phone that I'm letting you borrow. But I'm going to tell you, in the long run, these kids are going to be up there and talk about how their parents took away their phone and said, no, you're going to read a book. No, you're going to go help your brothers and sisters. No, you're going to do something different. You don't get on the phone. They're going to talk about how that made a big difference in the life. Not only because you're teaching them discipline and you're watching what friends are saying to them, but because you're now making them do something constructive rather than being stuck on a phone. Can you help me with that? Yeah. You're welcome, kids. Second, where I need your help. Okay, there's three things. Number two. Kids, how many of you have your own personal space to put your clothes or where you can sleep? Raise your hand. Once again, you don't. That's their space. Parents, don't forget, that's your room that you're lending them. If you want to make money, kick them out, invite a stranger and charge them. No, don't do that. But you're allowed to go through their stuff. You're allowed to snoop. You're allowed to do whatever it does to raise your child right. There's so many things out there. And the only thing that's going to make a critical difference is your eyes, your ears, your heart, and your spine. It's hard. We don't want to do that to our children. We want to trust them. But at the same time, they're children. People prey on children. And we're here to protect them. All of us. All of us. Number three, believe your teachers. When your teacher calls you or your teacher reaches out to you and the kid says, nah, nombre, puro mentiras, my teacher forgot, right? Believe the teacher. Teachers are very busy. More busy than you can ever imagine. Grading papers, doing what the administrators want, organizing these events. So if they take the time to call or talk to you or write an email, it's because they're trying to tell you something. They need your help. And you as parents have a right to say, ah, perfect time to meet the teacher. Students, if you don't want your parents to come meet the teacher, then do the right thing all the time and get straight A's and always do the right thing. Too many times now we want to say, no, the teacher's this, the teacher's not doing this. In middle school, a teacher could have up to 120 students with all the papers and everything that's going on in their life. And then they reach out to you. It's because they care. Maybe they don't reach out to you. Email them. Reach out to me. I want to know how so-and-so's going. Is he talking in class? Is he trying to get the attention of the girl in front of him? We got to work on your pickup lines. It's a joke. We're old. All right. So those three things, parents, if you commit to doing those things, I will see you at graduation, and you will be very excited as your son or daughter are walking across the stage. This is a magical moment because in Garland ISD, we've been in La Noticias, the paper, all these things because of all the opportunities that are here. When your kid goes to high school, they can go to college and high school now. They don't have to wait till after high school to go. If they want a career in welding, in being an electrician, going into any type of career they want, we have it here. They can get certified. They can be a firefighter before they even graduate. All of the opportunities are here, but they gotta walk straight. They gotta pick their friends. You got to be making sure they make the right decisions. You got to call the counselors and make sure they're in the right classes. You as a parent still get to parent these days. And the more we get them away from the phones and all those influences, the better they're going to be. Because your family got it right. Your family is here today. They are thriving. But it takes all of us. So I'm going to do my part. I need your help to do your part. So then in life, they can do their part. Buenas noches, felicidades, and we love you. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you.
That concludes our program. Thank you so much for coming. Congratulations, students. Could you also give a round of applause to my amazing teams? They're the ones in red and black, because they love me so much that they wore red and black tonight, for putting on these amazing programs. Thank you so much, and good night.